Good morning, Elasmere boys. Today we will start the soil erosion section of the chapter Soil Resources. As you can see in the screen, this is a soil erosion diagram where different pictures of soil erosion is present, and we can say that soil erosion may be defined as the detachment and transportation of soil by agents of denudation. Denudation agents are what? Weathering, running water, wind, etc. The depletion of soil and its nutrients is further speeded up by faulty and unscientific methods of farming. So soil erosion thus occurs when the rate of removal of soil particles and soil nutrients is an excess rate of soil formation. There are different types of soil erosion we will get. The first one we will get is sheet erosion. As you can see in the picture, when there is torrential downpour in the hilly region such as Himalayas, hills of Northeast India and the Nilgiris, the steep slopes stimulate the erosive power of rain, causing sheet erosion over the vast stretches of land. As you can see in the picture, vast stretches of land, the vegetation cover and the soil is being removed, and it's called a sheet erosion. On the plains which are more or less level, the speed up is slower. But when the erosion happens in the hilly region, it is huge. Okay. However, where rivers overflow the banks of the floods, the surrounding plains, as in the case of Brahmaputra, Kosi in Bihar, Chambal in Rajasthan, Damodar and Ganga in West Bengal, the damage done to the soil is tremendous, resulting rugged topography. In fact, heavy rainfall is more destructive than the same amount of precipitation over a longer period of time. Let's look at the next level of erosion, which is the gully erosion. The gully erosion takes place when the water runs down or gushes in distinct paths, forming hills which deepen to form ravines or gullies leading to the bedrock. Okay. This gully erosion creates areas of badlands which cannot to be put any use till soil restoration takes place. Such a type of gully erosion is prevalent in plateau countries, especially in Chambal valleys. Okay. Let's look at the other factors of soil erosion or other types. There are types called by wind, where the wind strength and direction also creates a powerful agent blowing away fine particles of sands. Fine particles of sands and depositing them in other areas, rendering both areas unproductive. Apart from that, as you can see in the picture, the human population also increases the demand on the land, increases human settlements, cultivation, overgrazing, improper techniques of cultivation, deforestation, and it leads to soil erosion. We can see this kind of soil erosion in Western Ghat, Chotanagpur Plateau, Shivalik Hills, Northeast Hill States, Telangana Plateau and Malwa Plateau region. Let's move to the next part, which is the consequences of soil erosion. Consequences we can say as effects of soil erosion. Let's look at the hilly area, what effect it can give by soil erosion. Overgrazing, deforestation, improper methods of farming, road construction, as you can see in this picture, road construction, are most improper methods that will lead to loosening the soil with extensive gullies, landslip and flash floods. See this picture over here. Due to the flash floods, all the cars are being moved away. Here, the loosening of the landslips. Lands are no matter in the hilly region, the road are being constructed, but due to landslip, it's getting broken down. Overgrazing over here in this picture, we can see lots of animals are present. So overgrazing is another problem lead to hilly area. So improper methods of farming, poor management of agricultural land and forest in the northeastern hill states result in landslide, flood and sheet erosion. Let's move back to the next set of area, which is the desert area. In arid zone, high velocity of winds carry loose sand, pebbles, gravels, weathered rock materials and tend to settle them as sand dunes. Thus, desertification, we can say, continuously intensified. Loss of invaluable topsoil. We know what is topsoil already. Topsoil, due to the intensive farming over the years and negligence of soil protection factor, lead to unproductivity, which results in poor crop yield. Okay, as the topsoil is being removed, we know topsoil is the most important layer of the soil since it contains humus. So once it is removed, unproductivity is and poor crop yield is being overplaced in the desertic areas. So what are the things we can do for soil conservation? It is very important, as soil conservation refers to the step taken to protect the soil from erosion. Farmers are initiated into the main soil conservation methods as appropriate to their farmlands. It is very important that we do soil conservation, as the soil are of the most importance of for plant growth, including cultivation. It is necessary to protect the soil from erosion. This protection of the topsoil, which is constantly being shifted by the wind, water from one area to another area, is a main objective of soil conservation. Okay, there are plenty of methods we follow for soil conservation. Out of that, there are mainly two different types of preventive measures. One is agronomic measures, another is mechanical measures. So let's look at the agronomic measures first. So as we can talk about that, the agronomic measures or soil conversion will make it the prevent of the degradation, will reduce erosion and will leave the soil for a longer period of time, conserve it in a proper state so that we can produce crops inside of it. Let's look at the agronomic measures. The first left hand side picture pointing to strip cropping and also terraced farming is present, are also practiced as they are improved methods of farming. Okay, the second picture is a primitive method of slash and burn or zooming that has been completely banned. We cannot do this method anymore. Rather, it is being replaced by the methods called crop rotation or multiple cropping. Crop rotation means after a certain period of time, first we are having the crop of rice, then no more rice production. We are replacing it by wheat, again replacing by something else. Multiple cropping is at the same time, some in a big land, some portion is dedicated to rice, some portion is dedicated to wheat, like that. Apart from that, farmers add organic matters, grow leguminous plant and add fertilizers, also rotate crop so that a leaching can be prevented. It is very important of this agronomic measures. Let's look at what are the rest agronomic measures we can take. Planning of rural development, people's participation and awareness of ecological programs and association with the agroforestry, as you can see, are one of the important agronomic measures. We can move forward to the next agronomic measure, which is at the desert area, planning of shelter blades of trees. You can see how they are standing at the perpendicular direction to the wind, checks the migration of sand dunes from the third desert. Shelter belts have been able to prevent also the coastal erosion. These are the agronomic measures we can see. Apart from that, we have some mechanical measures. The first mechanical measure is a contour ploughing or contour banding. What it happened? A ploughing method that respect the natural shape or contour lines or land area. By ploughing along the contour lines, the farmer creates mini terraces which discourage swift and water runoff. Water doesn't erode the soil over here, but rather rank soaks it and can be used for plants for growth. Let's look at to the next mechanical measures. In the mechanical measures, dry land development through an irrigation network, the drought prone area program, that is DPAP, has been initiated by the government of India, along with watershed management. Okay, watershed management, we can go through that through an explanation later on in a small video. This will help in the protection of fragile mountain ecosystem and also the flood prone areas, so that the soil erosion can be stopped or can be controlled. Apart from that, technical and financial assistance is given to farmers by the government to adopt soil conversion method. It has been estimated that 50 million hectares of conserved lands are covered by these soil conservation measures. Another 150 million hectares of land continue to be affected by soil erosion, but are being tackled as well by IISWC and the government planning related to soil conservation. So this is the way we can see what are the soil conservation methods and what are the types of soil erosion. That's all for this chapter. Thank you, boys. Stay safe at home and do not go out in this pandemic situation. Please maintain lockdown and tell your parents to be stay at home also. Take care of them. Please tell your comments about the procedure of studying, what we are doing right now as online study. Thank you. We will move to the next video very soon.